Hi everyone, this is Neelam and welcome to my channel Answer by Neelam Sachang. Continuing the series of the acrylic paints over the canvas of the best air purifying indoor plants. Now the second one in the series is the Fiddly Fig plant. So you will see how I create that. The drawing has already been done. If you do not know how to draw, please follow my instructions from my watercolor tutorial of the magnolias. I will share the link in the description below. Please click and see that. The drawing procedure has been explained there. So now here we will learn how to paint with the acrylic paints. The drawing procedure remains the same. So let's have a quick look at the video tutorial of this plant first, and then I will explain about it later. Let's have a look. Alright, so you saw the video and you must be wondering, there was already the green color, that why is the green color there? So let me explain it. The green color in the background is there from the leftover paint of this snake painting. So I started this painting first, then the leftover paint was carried forward to paint the background to add another layer so that the paint sticks nicely. Acrylic paints need some prepping on the canvas so that the paints are not wasted too much, the quantities are spent less. If you cover the base with a nice primer first, they work better. So if you do not have a primer, don't worry, just put a thin layer of the paint or the leftover paint from any other painting instead of throwing or washing away that paint. Put it on another canvas, put it at the background of another canvas, and you can paint something over it. It's so opaque and it's so nice. Acrylic paints are very nice thing. So fiddleleaf fig plants, you can see the value addition thing. Light and shadows, yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho, if the veins of this backside of the leaf are clearly visible as compared to the veins of these front side of the leaf, where the veins of the leaf are not that prominent on the front side, they are more visible on the back side of the leaf. So what you have to do is add the shadow at the opposite side of the vein where the light is coming from, and you can see that the vein is utha hua, it is risen, and here it is daba hua, that is a little pressed, and the leaf blade is actually risen. So you will make these shiny, and here at the back side your veins will be more shinier and prominent. So that is how you create the difference of the front and the back of something and any surface. If you want to add the texture, that is something you can play with the lights, and you can add that there. Now this painting took me about 3 hours or 3+ hours because I was adding so much of the detail later. I was mixing and merging the colors. Acrylic paints dry out really fast. So you have to be either really fast or you have to follow another method to add that shiny surface, or it takes so much time. You put up the first layer, then you add the light and the dark and light and the dark and keep on mixing till you achieve what you are looking for. So that is the same technique that I have done here. You can see that these parts are a little shiny and the other parts are a little dark because they are underexposed to light. So this procedure takes a little time. Paint the base cover, the background, add the final detail, add the final touches, and you are done. It's not very difficult. So I think if I can do it, you can do it a lot better than me. So please keep doing, keep painting, keep creating, and share your results with me on my Instagram account, that is Neelam Sachan Artist. And I would love to see your works, and you can see more of my botanical works or other works as well. You can see there on my Instagram account, that is the real time sharing. And if you like this video, please share this with everyone. And subscription to the channel is necessary, so do not forget, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification button. Am I forgetting anything? No, I think that's done. Do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, and hit the notification button. So that is something I really need to learn. It will take time. So please bear with me, and do not forget to give your feedback and what is it that you would like to see next in my tutorial videos. Till then, keep creating, stay happy, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.